Opeth is one of the most important progressive metal bands ever. Their 2001 album Blackwater Park is a seminal record in the evolution of heavy progressive metal. There's a lot of musical elements that make Blackwater Park real good. And today I'm going to talk about one in particular, and that's Opeth's use of compound meter. Let's head to the prog school. So what is compound meter? To explain this a little bit better, I'm gonna go get some eggs. I'm going to view each egg as 1/8 note. The rows represent the number of beats, and the columns represent the number of notes per beat. As it is, this carton of eggs has 6 beats, and each beat has 2 notes. This is what is called simple meter. In simple meter, there are 2 notes per beat. This would be written as 6/4 in standard musical notation. Let's reimagine this carton of eggs. Now there are 4 beats, and each beat has 3 notes. This is called compound meter. In compound meter, each beat has 3 notes, and this would be notated as 12/8. By changing the way 12/8 notes are 12 egg notes, I can't, that's so dumb. By changing the way these 12 notes are divided, the feel can be drastically changed. This is the reason why 6/4 and 12/8 are both used in music, even though they both have 12/8 notes. It's because they're subdivided differently. 12/8 is one of the most commonly used time signatures. You can find it in everything from blues shuffles to jazz, early rock music, flamenco, traditional West African music, and in the music of Opeth. This 12/8 compound feel lends a heaviness to the music of Opeth and brings an infectious groove to a lot of the riffs on Blackwater Park. Because 12/8 is most associated with music that originally stemmed from West Africa, blues, jazz, rock and roll, etc., these grooves bring a bluesy, almost swing-like quality to a lot of the music on Blackwater Park. Now, Opeth does play in 4/4 fairly often as well. Most of the song Bleak and Blackwater Park from this album are in 4/4, but they tend to lean into this compound 3-note-per-beat feel a lot more than other bands in this genre. Here's the 6/4 I talked about earlier, but let's look at just the top row. I'm going to divide this in half to get 2 groups of 3. This is the most common way to hear 6/4 or 6/8 subdivided. The denominator of the time signature doesn't really matter, as that's based more on the tempo of the actual music. This way of dividing 6/4 makes it a compound meter because it's being treated as 2 groups of 3. The 6 individual beats are divided into 2, like a simple meter, but the overarching feel of the whole measure is 2 groups of 3. Here's the double bass groove. It's going to start in 12/8 with 4 groups of 3, and then move to 6/4 with this overarching compound meter. Getting a handle on this particular groove change is going to give you a grasp on a good portion of the rhythms from this album. Opeth likes to use the 12-8 feel for heavier sections. Because there are more notes per beat, this works incredibly well for really energetic riffs. The 6-4 feel is used for heavy riffs as well, but also tends to be the main groove for the slower acoustic-led passages that Opeth are known for. Harvest, for example, is entirely in this 6-4 feel. Opeth will often go between these two grooves within one song or even within one section of a song. The very beginning of the album is a perfect example of this. At 55 seconds in the Leper Affinity, it switches from 6-4 to 12-8, and this helps to ramp up the energy here. This also happens at 5 minutes and 12 seconds in the Funeral Portrait. Sometimes they'll blend these two feels together. At 3 minutes and 35 seconds in the Leper Affinity, the compound 12-8 meter continues in the riffs and the kick and snare, while the cymbals hint at 6-4 by playing every quarter note. The last couple of minutes of the Funeral Portrait really play off these feel changes. The last thing to look at is this idea used in an odd time signature. So back to the eggs one more time. At 6:09 in The Drapery Falls, there are 3 bars of 5-4 and 1 bar of 6-4. The 5-4 bars are divided as 3-3-2-2, so I'm going to remove one egg from each of the last two columns. What you end up with is half of the measure with a compound feel and half of the measure with a simple feel. You also only get 10 eggs, in which case you should get a refund. This 5-4 bar also feels kind of like 6-4 with one beat cut off. This is a great example of blending these two rhythmic feels together, and it shows how thoughtful Opeth is with how they use these grooves. If you haven't experimented with compound meter before, it can give you a lot of cool options, and I recommend you give a few of these ideas a shot. These kind of grooves are really useful and can be molded in a lot of cool ways, as is obvious in the music of Opeth. And if you haven't checked out Blackwater Park before, cook yourself up some eggs and listen to it right now. And if you enjoyed this lesson, subscribe, hit the bell notification, like, comment, share, all that good stuff. Till next time! Stay proggy.